In our last episode, I showed you the top 5 things you must do after installing Kali. If you missed it, don't worry, I got you covered. Just check out the link below. What's up, Purple Team? Dan here. In today's escapade, I'll guide you through the essentials of becoming a professional hacker. From choosing the right programming languages to mastering the tools, I'll help you map out a learning plan tailored to your future in this fascinating field. Make sure to stay tuned until the end. The last tip will blow your mind. Now let's get started. Number 1, practice and mentorship. In your quest to master hacking, two elements will be your steadfast companions. First and foremost, practice. It's through hands-on experience, even if it involves making mistakes, that you truly progress. Secondly, having a mentor or guide by your side can be invaluable. Their wisdom and insights can illuminate your path and accelerate your learning journey. I remember when I first started exploring cybersecurity. I was eager, but felt lost in the sea of information. It was only when I found a mentor who patiently guided me and encouraged me to practice that things started to click. Their advice helped me avoid common pitfalls and gave me the confidence to experiment and learn from my mistakes. So, don't hesitate to seek out a mentor or community where you can learn from others' experiences. Remember, practice and mentorship can make all the difference in your hacking journey. Number 2, honing your skills. In the realm of cybersecurity, there are 4 essential skills you can work on: programming, computer networks, operating systems, including Kali Linux, and various related skills. Think of these as the 4 pillars of your foundation. As you delve into this field, you'll find that these pillars often intersect and support each other. Don't stress too much about where to start. Just go with what resonates with you. Remember, there's no magical formula for success in cybersecurity. Whatever you learn from these core areas will be valuable. Rest assured, your time will be well spent, and you'll continually build your expertise. To guide your choice, let me share my own experience. I kicked off my journey with web programming, diving into PHP, HTML, and CSS. Armed with a guidebook, I fired up Visual Studio and embarked on crafting my initial websites. They were far from perfect. Any seasoned programmer might have chuckled at them, but that's beside the point. The key is to get started and keep practicing. After getting a handle on PHP, I moved on to Python, exploring it through online courses. Python is crucial for conducting penetration testing due to its versatility, ease of use, and extensive library support. To hone my skills in Python and familiarize myself with Linux, I utilized virtual machines running the Kali Linux OS. This multifaceted approach to learning proved to be highly effective. I then expanded my skill set to software development, mastering languages like C and C++, which enabled me to understand system programming, embedded systems, and software applications. Remember, learning is not about becoming an expert overnight. It's about gaining a solid grasp of the subject in line with your projects and objectives. So, don't feel pressured to master programming languages from A to Z in a sequential manner. Nobody does that. Keep in mind that consistent practice, patience, and guidance are your greatest allies on this journey. The most effective way to enhance your hacking skills is through hands-on projects. For instance, my curiosity about how websites function and how hackers are able to hack them led me to embark on various projects, including creating my own web application firewalls. Diving into web languages, I aimed to build a website to share my knowledge. This venture brought me closer to the realms of networks and systems. To host my site, I rented a Linux server from Amazon Web Services, familiarized myself with its operation, mastered Linux commands, and delved into system and network administration. Focusing on web security became a priority to safeguard my clients' sites. This required a deep understanding of network protocols such as HTTPS, DNS, ARP, and IP, among others. Each project not only expanded my skill set, but also provided valuable practical experience in the world of hacking and cybersecurity. Number 3, learning. To learn more about networks, I took CompTIA courses on Udemy, such as A+, Network+, and Security+. You learn a lot because these courses provide comprehensive coverage of networking fundamentals, protocols, security principles, and practical skills, all essential for understanding and working with networks effectively in various IT and cybersecurity roles. Soft skills are also important. Here, you'll delve into soft but useful knowledge, particularly English, social engineering, and an understanding of the standards, references, and laws relevant to the field. For instance, I took courses to get my Certified Security Systems Professional certification, which now I showcase proudly. This helped me gain a deep understanding of the legal and regulatory framework surrounding cybersecurity, which is crucial for understanding compliance and interaction within the cybersecurity domain. The key is to carve out your own path. Now you're equipped with everything you need to progress swiftly and extensively. But let me give you some pro tips that I'm sure will be invaluable to get you where you want to be. And before I do that, if you enjoyed this content, hit like and smash the subscribe button. Your support means the world to me. Number 5, Dan's pro tips. If you begin today, you'll always be a step ahead of those who start tomorrow. You don't need a massive budget or a formal diploma. An internet connection and a computer are all you need, and you don't have to dedicate 10 hours a day to learning. Just take that first step. If you're leaning towards starting with programming, focus on algorithms and data structures. If you're unsure about which language to begin with, Python is a great choice. It's both popular and crucial in the field. I'll include all the necessary links in the description to get you started, including a website that offers the fundamentals of a programming language in a single source code. If you're interested in starting with networks, I highly recommend Professor Messer. Begin by understanding the basics of the OSI model and TCP/IP. Get to know how certain protocols like HTTPS, DNS, ARP, and IP work. From there, you can explore vulnerabilities in these protocols and delve into Wi-Fi security. Tools like Wireshark are invaluable for grasping the TCP/IP model in a practical context. If you're keen on starting with systems, consider downloading and installing a Linux distribution, such as Kali Linux. Familiarize yourself with the architecture of Linux, the terminal, and various commands. Incorporate security tools or shell scripts into your learning process. A fantastic resource for all this is a website called Linux Journey, which provides comprehensive tutorials and guides. If you're interested in starting with related skills, focus on enhancing your social engineering skills. Learn to adopt the mindset of an attacker by exploring different scenarios, attacks, and scams, along with their corresponding defense strategies. If you eventually work in the field, your aim will be to address and rectify these issues. At the core, a hacker is someone deeply knowledgeable about computers, which can translate into various roles and situations. For instance, a coder is a programmer who might focus on identifying vulnerabilities in code or developing antivirus software. But an ethical hacker is an expert in breaking things. This person is hired to test a company's defenses by exploiting systems with the purpose of enhancing security. Let me put it this way. You can be in offensive cybersecurity as part of a red team or in defensive cybersecurity, as it is with blue teams. Or even better, you can be part of the purple team, just like me. In my case, I do both. I break systems and then fix them. How cool is that? It's a big field with so many opportunities. If you're feeling a bit overwhelmed and you're not too sure where to start, here are two of my videos that I'm sure you will enjoy. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. Thanks for watching, and peace out.